Hi, I'm Sardar Yegulov, senior writer for InfoWorld at IDG. In this video, we're going to talk about the Python programming language, what it is, what it's good for, what it can do for you, and when it may not be the best choice for a project. The Python language is tremendously popular right now. The Tyobi Index, which ranks languages by their usage, routinely features Python somewhere in the top 5, next to Java, C and C++, and C Sharp. So what makes Python so popular? First, Python is easy to work with. It takes less lines of code in Python to accomplish many common tasks than in other languages. Reading from a website, processing text or data formats like JSON, or crunching numbers. These are all things Python helps you do faster and with less hassle. Second, Python's powerful enough that robust, enterprise-grade software can be built with it. Many major internet brands, like Pinterest, Dropbox, Quora, and Instagram, use Python to build their offerings. Others, like Google, Netflix, and Facebook, use Python for automation, management, and infrastructure provisioning. Third, Python has a galaxy of third-party software packages, or libraries, available for it. With those libraries, you can build websites and web apps, desktop applications, and command line tools. Those libraries can be installed in minutes with Python's own built-in utilities. If there's some high-level task you want to accomplish, odds are there's a Python package for it, and you can get up and running with it right away. Python's made a name for itself as the language for data science and machine learning. The real heavy lifting is performed by libraries written in faster languages, but Python provides them with a convenient front end that's easier to work with than using those languages directly. So when is Python not a good choice? First, if you're creating system-level software, device drivers, operating system kernels, anything that works directly with hardware. Python can interface with the lower levels of a system through its libraries, but it isn't a good choice for creating those low-level components. Another area where Python falls short, at least for now, is when you want to create standalone applications you want to distribute across multiple platforms. It's less painful now than it was before, but languages like Rust and Go still have better cross-platform build tools. Finally, there's when performance is an absolute priority. Python is generally fast enough, and performance-critical parts of a Python program can often be made to run as fast as or near to the speed of C. But if performance comes first and last and always, Python won't be an ideal choice. If you have questions or want to suggest something to explore with Python, please add a comment below. And don't forget to subscribe to the IDG Tech Talk channel on YouTube. And if you like this video, please hit the like and share buttons. For more Python tips, be sure to follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and InfoWorld.com.